Foundational or Basic Chemistry, Part 1. We'll look at the following outline. Definition of chemistry. Matter. Elements. Valencies of elements. Radicals and valencies. And then finally, formation of compounds from valencies. Let's begin the journey. Chemistry deals with the composition, properties, and uses of matter. Right? For example, water, H2O, has the following composition, property, and uses. Okay, the composition of water is hydrogen and oxygen. One of the property is a colorless substance, and then it can be used for making solution. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Examples are table, chair, human, water, and so on. Anything you can feel, you can touch, and that occupies space is called matter. States of matter. Matter can exist in three physical states. As a solid, it has a definite volume and shape, all right, hard substances. As a liquid, it has a definite volume but no definite shape. It takes the shape of its container. Okay, then finally, as a gas, matter has neither a definite volume nor a definite shape, that is, it fills the entire container, for example, in a gas cylinder. Changes of state. Matter can change its states from gas to liquid, from liquid to gas, and so on and so forth. These processes are given below, from solid to liquid, melting. From liquid to gas by evaporation, from gas to solid by what we call deposition, and then the reverse, from solid to gas, sublimation, from gas to liquid, condensation, and then finally from liquid to solid by freezing. Changes of matter. Matter can change from one form to another. We have the physical changes. This is one which is easily reversed and in which no new substance are formed. Examples are the dissolution of salt in water. All right, it's a physical change because you can easily get the salt back from the water. The melting of solid to liquid. You can easily reverse the process. The liquid can also become the solid back. All right, the separation of mixtures by evaporation, distillation, and sublimation. The magnetization and demagnetization of iron rods. Chemical change. Chemical change is one which is not easily reversed and in which a new substance is formed. Right? Examples, we have the rusting of iron. You can reverse the process. When iron rusts, it has rust. Okay. Fermentation and decay of substances. Whatever that has fermented cannot be reversed. Dissolution of metal or limestone in an acid cannot be reversed. Changes in electrochemical cells cannot be reversed. And then finally, addition of water to quick lime. Next, elements. An element is a substance which cannot be split into simpler units by an ordinary chemical process. Okay? An element is a pure substance because it cannot be separated by physical means. It is pure. Okay? And finally, elements constitute the building units of all other substances. There are about 109 elements, okay? 90 of them are natural, okay? The rest elements are made artificially in the laboratory. Elements are represented with symbols, either from the first letter or a completion of the first and the second. For example, H is gotten from the first letter of hydrogen and N from the first letter of nitrogen. Ca from the combination of the first and the second, then Ne for neon, first and second also. And then some are gotten from Latin word like potassium and sodium. Okay? The first 30 elements are given below. Pause the video, study it, know them. All right? Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, number 5, boron, 6, carbon, 7, nitrogen, 8, oxygen, 9, fluorine, 10, neon, 11, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, 14, silicon, 15, phosphorus, 16, sulfur, 17, chlorine, 18, argon, 19, potassium, and 20, calcium, 21, scandium, all right, 22, titanium. Their symbols are also there, note them, please. 23, vanadium, 24, chromium, 25, manganese, 26, iron, 27, cobalt, 28, nickel, 29, copper, and then finally, zinc is the number 30 element. Valency. Valency is the combining power of an element. The combining power of an element, all right? It is defined as the number of hydrogen atoms that can combine with one atom of that element. It can be regarded as the oxidation number of an element. Let's look at the valency of some elements. Valencies are very important because they help us to form compounds. Right? So elements and their valencies, the basic ones. Aluminium, the valency is +3. Bromine is -1. Calcium, +2. Carbon can exist in two valencies, 2 or 4. Chlorine, -1. Copper, 1 or 2. Hydrogen, +1. Right? Iodine is -1. Right? More. Iron is 2 or 3. Lead, 2 or 4. Manganesium is +2. Nitrogen, 3 or 5. Oxygen, -2. Right? Phosphorus, 3 or 5. Potassium is +1. Silver is +1, sodium +1, mercury can exist as 1 or 2, and then finally sulfur 2, 4, or 6, and then zinc is +2. Okay. Valencies of the noble gases are nil, that is, they are zero. All right, within the elements, some noble gases are given below: helium, neon, argon, and krypton. So their valencies are nil or zero. Now, valencies enable us to write the formula of a compound. All right, when you bring valencies together from various elements, they help you to form compounds. Okay, for example, if we have magnesium and calcium and chlorine, rather, to form a compound between them, their valencies are very important. When they combine, you have MgCl. The one will go to the magnesium, the two will go to the chlorine. magnesium chloride will then be formed. If I have aluminium and oxygen, valency of aluminium is plus 3. Valency of oxygen is minus 2. I'll cross the 2 to the aluminium, the 3 to the oxygen. Then I'm going to have Al2O3, which is aluminium oxide. Is that okay? All right. Now, we also have what we call radicals. They are a group of atoms that function as a single unit in chemical reactions. All right? We're going to look at some radicals and their valencies and see how we can use them to form some compounds. All right? Okay? We have the first one, hydroxide, OH, group of element, oxygen and hydrogen joined together. The valency is minus 1. We have ammonium, NH4, all right, group of element joined together. Valency is also minus 1. We have triazole nitrate 5, NO3, valency is minus 1. We have trioxocarbonate 4, CO3, valency minus 2. We have tetraazole sulfate 6, SO4, valency minus 2. We have dioxazole nitrate 5, NO2, valency is minus 1. And then finally, we have hydrogen triazole carbonate 4, HCO3, valency is minus 1. Now, we can form compounds from elements and radicals, all right, by knowing their valencies. Let's look at the example. Let's say we have calcium and oxygen and OH. Calcium is 2. The valency of OH is minus 1. When they cross, we are going to have Ca1OH2, which is calcium hydroxide. All right? Is it clear? Let's also have aluminium and SO4. Okay? Aluminium is plus 3. SO4 is minus 2. When they cross, you have Al2. The minus signs, the signs are not important when forming the compound. Al2, SO4, 3. Close the bracket, 3 outside. Aluminium sulfate. You're going to do the following exercise. All right? Construct and name some compounds with elements and radicals using their valencies. All right, for more videos, ensure you subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.